Do you see the human tendency? Do you see the human response? Rather than centering on ownership lawsuit, or centering on gratitude for receiving pain for work, they center your lives on the spirit from the church. As in, comparing themselves to others, their work, their time to others. Now, in that week, this is a classic feeling. Some would say in this room, what is the big deal, Pastor, about human comparison? You know what it is? It's the troubling dynamic. It's that human comparison also immediately becomes jealousy, discrimination. As in, that person could not possibly be as worthy as me. Not as good as me, or as smart as me, or rich as me. There's no way that that person deserves what I have. Look at their skin color. Look at their gender. Look at their sexual preference. Look at their costumes and the way they eat. Look at their wearing. Look what they're eating. Just look at them from the outside. That person is less worthy. In this economic system, standing around waiting to retire that day, possibly not dressed too well, perhaps not the most put together in terms of convenience. And there was a consequence to all of this. If they did not get hired, they would not. Their families would not. So the implications were quite great for the employees. They had no time. The meaning of inequity, of unfairness, of favoritism, of bias. However, when we see what is terrible, it does not affect the essence, really, the sequence, the timing, whether you were first or last, makes no difference in the economy of God. We are all the same, love the same, equally wise with the divine, and in God's kingdom, all are fed. This is the sign of God's creation. grace is God's standard, it is God's kingdom. The kingdom of heaven is like generosity. It is benevolent for all, giving for all, plentiful for all, lavishing, overflowing, outpouring, the last come first, the first come last. Oh, that's what is working in you to hear about. You tell me God doesn't care how much money I have in the bank, how many degrees, how often I come to church. God loves you as much as God will ever love you now. There is nothing you can do that will make God love you more. Or more.